Okay, fine. So we can start, right? So that's fine. Thanks, Parminder.
Sure. No issues.
Okay, so we will go ahead with the next planning strategies in our today's session. Okay, that is make to order and some other planning strategies also we will look into. As we saw in our last session, there are a couple of planning strategies are not there in the system. So I try to configure it. So probably in SAP best practice, we used to get around 50 to 60 planning strategies already configured. But in our training system, we don't have that planning strategy. Even 20 number planning strategy was also not there, 30 also not there. So I tried to configure. Before going ahead, we will quickly, you know, recap our last session, what we discussed in our last session. In our last session, we discussed majorly about the three planning strategies, that is make to stock net requirement planning, gross requirement planning, that is 11 number planning strategy, and planning with final assembly, that is 40 number. So, and also we discuss more about the consumption mode, and we were, you know, struggling to get some more details about the consumption mode in planning strategy 10 and 11. But actually I also gone through some SAP notes. The consumption mode for planning strategy and 10 and 11 is not actually activated. Basically, planning strategy 10 and 11 are made to stock, okay? So our plan order, the consumption mode is basically used to consume the plan independent requirement based on incoming sales order. So in 10 number and 11 number strategy, we are supposed to do our planning with the help of plan independent requirement. And then we are creating the plan order and production order. So basically for 10 and 11 number planning strategy, whatever the production order we are creating, it will go and consume the last, you know, PIR open, the last PIR. Just I will explain you. So, and then we will move ahead. Okay. So let's say today's date is 12th, right? So for 1st December, I'll put it here first. Okay. Was December 20, okay. Now let's say, take an example here. We are somewhere on a 12th of December, right? Here, okay. So we do have a plan independent requirement created, okay. Plan independent requirement created on, let's say, these many days of 100 quantity. I'm just putting the same plan independent requirement in that fashion, okay, here. Now there is one sales order coming. So if you see here, the what we discuss in the 10 number strategy, sorry, 40 number strategy, my incoming sales order will try to consume my plan independent requirement, right? So just for 10 number strategy, we are consuming our plan independent requirement when we are completing our production in the 11. In the 10 number strategy, after completion of production, when we are delivering it to the sales order, our PIR is supposed to consume. Now for 10 and 11, when I'm, you know, delivering or when I'm completing the production, what system is doing? System is always trying to do consume the first open PIR, the last PIR. It will not check whether you are working on a backward consumption mode or forward consumption mode. Basically, this consumption logic in the planning strategy will be used in 40 number kind of planning strategy. Incoming sales order will try to consume your PIR, okay? Now here, let's say I'm putting a sales order of 600 quantity, okay? I'm having a requirement, let's say 40th of December, okay? Of let's say 600 quantity. That time system will go and check which plan order or which PIR it has to consume. Now if we are working with 40 number planning strategy and we have mentioned backward consumption of 10 days, then system will do and go and try to consume the open PIR backward, right? First, let's say we have put the consumption mode of 2, saying backward consumption of 10 days and then forward consumption of 10 days. Then system will try to consume the 600 with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 days back. Let's say I'm putting only 2 days here. 2 days backward and let's say 10 days forward. In that case, how system will do? Total requirement is 640, but we do have these plan orders open, PIRs there, and we'll try to consume 1, 2, this is 200. Then it will not go ahead and try to consume this PIR, that will still open. Again, it will go and try to consume the forward because my consumption mode is backward and forward. If we are putting only forward, then in that case, system will try to consume this plan independent requirement. If it is only backward, then it will try to consume only this PIR. So that's how our consumption logic works in case of 40 number planning strategy. For 10 and 11, since it's a make to stock, when we are doing any plan order in between, let's say this is the plan order in case of 10 or 11, okay, plan order, and we are creating one plan order here. System will try to consume this PIR first, then this, then this, then this. This is standard SAP actually. I was thinking like it will work for the plan order also in the same fashion. That's what we were discussing in our last session. But for 10 and 11 number strategy, it will not work in that. In that case, system will try to consume the first PIR which is open in that period, okay? So that's what we discuss in the 10 number strategy, how it works, 11 number strategy, how it works, and also 40 number strategy, how system actually behaves. Now, before moving ahead, I just want to know if you have any kind of question. Next, we will discuss about the make to order strategy and remaining, you know, whatever we plan to discuss. Any questions? You can unmute and ask now. Okay. So we will go ahead with make to order the strategy, that is 20. Now it is there in the system. We will first see here how it actually works, and then we will try to run quick scenario on that. As we discussed, like make to order planning strategy will be, you know, we will start our production once we will get the sales order from the customer. Before sales order, we cannot start the production in make to order planning strategy. Hence, in the make to stock, we are starting our, you know, production with the plan independent requirement. But in make to stock, we are able to start with plan independent requirement. But in case of make to order, we need to have a sales order first. Let's say we do have one sales order, okay, SO1. At the same time, we have sales order second also. There are two sales order with two different dates, let's say, okay. I'm putting here sales order 2. Then once we punch the sales order in the system, we used to run material requirement MRP. Then system will create the plan order, first plan for first sales order and second plan for second sales order. There will be two individual plan order with respect to the sales order that will get converted to the production order. In the production order itself, we will have a sales order reference, and then we will get the warehouse stock against sales order. So I'm putting here as a sales order 1 warehouse stock, or sales order stock we can say here in case of sales order 1 stock. Okay, the same way we will get sales order second stock here. Okay. And then we system will be allow us to deliver this sales order stock against only this sales order. It will not allow us to deliver this stock against this sales order. So basically this is a very, you know, sales order specific requirement system used to plan, system used to get the production against that sales order, and it will allow us to do the delivery against the same sales order only. In make to stock, we can deliver any incoming sales order. Here also we are able to deliver it any incoming sales order. The same way in 40 also is a make to stock one. Incoming sales order try to consume the PIR, and we are supposed to deliver the stock from warehouse. But in case of make to order, we will get the stock with respect to sales order only, and system will allow us to deliver it back against that sales order only. That's how our make to order planning strategy work. As simple as that. So what I'll do, I will quickly go to the system and, you know, I will try to create one couple of sales order, and we'll see how it actually look into the system. Okay. I will log into a remote desktop. Meanwhile, if you have any kind of question, you can ask, guys.